So far, you have seen the main PV system topologies, their design rules, and some examples of specific PV systems. We shall now discuss the basic ideas involved in the economics of PV systems. The economics in the field of photovoltaics can be discussed at several levels. We can consider the consumer, manufacturers, installation companies, or even the technology level. For a comparison with other energy sources, we generally consider the economics at a grid level. In this video, we will start our discussion at the consumer level. At this level, we will discuss the concept of payback period. In finance, the payback period is defined as the amount of time required to recover the cost of an investment. So how can we translate this to the consumer level? Our consumer is a homeowner who installs a rooftop PV system. The homeowner puts up an initial investment that covers the cost of the PV system. The costs are recovered over the years as the PV system offsets the electricity bills. This can be understood using a simple example. Let's look at the Smith family, for instance, who has installed a 1 kilowatt peak PV system at an initial investment cost of 4,000 euros. The family's average electricity consumption is such that they receive an annual electricity bill of 2,000 euros. After installation of the PV system, roughly 800 euros worth of electricity is generated by the PV system each year. We can illustrate this situation in this graph. Here we see a straight line representing initial investment cost. Since the PV system has no maintenance cost, the overall cost of the system do not increase over the years. As the family uses more of the power produced by the PV system, it offsets the electricity bill accordingly. In our example, the amount saved is 800 euros per year. In other words, the family earns a return of 800 euros per year on their investment. As the years progress, the savings accumulate. At some point in time, the savings will exceed the cost of the investment. The period of time from the initial investment to this break-even point is called the payback period. In this case, the Smith family's PV system has a payback period of 5 years. Know that the payback period is not a fixed value, but rather depends on a number of factors. The location of the PV system is one of these factors. The sunnier the location will have a greater PV yield and therefore a shorter payback period. The amount of money saved by a PV system also depends on the electricity cost of the local grid. Finally, the initial cost of the PV system are also a major factor in deciding the payback period. The calculation involved in determining the payback period can become even more complex as more parameters are factored in. For instance, when we consider an extended period of time, generally the time value of money is taken into account. The time value of money factors in that a certain amount of money today will have a different purchasing power 10 years from now. Then there are also policy-related factors. Subsidies and feed-in tariffs can strongly affect both the initial investments as well as the savings over time. Let us briefly discuss the concept of feed-in tariffs in PV systems. The feed-in tariff is the rate that a consumer is paid for the electricity that a grid-connected PV system contributes to the local grid. There are two kinds of feed-in tariffs, namely the gross and the net tariff. The gross feed-in tariff is the amount paid for all the electricity generated by the PV system, regardless of the electricity consumption of the PV system owners. The net feed-in tariff is a higher rate. This rate is paid for the surplus electricity fed into the grid after subtracting off the domestic consumption. Now we will look into the concept of the levelized cost of electricity. The levelized cost of electricity is defined as the cost per kilowatt hour of electricity generated by a certain energy production system. It is generally used to compare the lifetime cost of projects based on various power sources. For the levelized cost, the overall cost of an energy plant during its useful lifetime are determined. This overall cost is combined with the overall energy generation of a plant over its lifetime to give an effective price per kilowatt hour. The calculation of the levelized cost can get quite complex depending on the number of parameters taken into consideration. In simple terms, if we know the annual yield of the PV system over its useful lifetime and the system cost, the levelized cost can be determined according to the shown formula. Here, AT is the total annual cost in year T, I0 is the initial investment, and ET is the annual energy yield. I is the discount rate to account for the time value of the money. The discount rate relates the worth of a certain amount of money in the future to the amount it is worth in the present. Based on the location of the PV system and the cost of the materials, the levelized cost of a PV project can vary strongly. Also, the discount rate used for the evaluation will have a big impact on the levelized cost value. For the producer, the levelized cost is a valuable indicator of the cost competitiveness of a certain energy technology. It is also a good price point indicator, since the producer will have to sell the power at a price greater than the levelized cost for a system to be profitable. Of course, the policy structured around PV energy, like feed-in tariffs, subsidies, and other incentives, will all play a role in determining the grid power prices. Finally, we will discuss the concept of grid parity. Grid parity represents a situation where the levelized cost of electricity from a renewable energy source is equal to the cost of purchasing power from the grid. There is, however, a significant difference between PV and other renewable technologies like wind turbines or hydropower. PV can be scaled down to the level of a single module. It therefore does not require high transmission and distribution costs, which are an essential part of hydro and wind turbines. This means that in the case of a grid parity, PV power is effectively competing with the retail grid price. Compared to the wholesale price, PV grid parity for retail grid prices can be achieved more easily, as shown in the graph. The graph shows the cumulative volume of installed PV systems on the horizontal axis. The installed volume has a direct correlation with time, for the installed PV capacity has strongly increased over the past decade. As capital costs decline with increasing volume, PV power is expected to become increasingly less expensive. The cost of fossil fuels, on the other hand, due to the limited availability and increasing emission costs, are expected to rise. This will increase the price of electricity from the grid. Keeping in mind the location dependency of the levelized cost, we can draw both a typical curve and a best curve for the price of solar power. Grid parity occurs when the curves for solar power price and grid price in the graph cross. The grid parity could be reached faster with the help of incentives and subsidies. It is said, however, that true grid parity occurs when the price of unsubsidized PV power matches the grid price. The grid parity is a very important indicator of the usefulness of a renewable energy technology. The closer a technology is to grid parity, the easier its integration in the local energy mix will be. New solar power plants are now being built in Dubai and India that already promise to deliver electricity at a price below that of conventional coal and gas-fired power plants. The Electricity and Water Authority in Dubai has received a bid to produce solar energy at a levelized cost of under $3 per kilowatt hour. Meanwhile, in Europe, the Fraunhofer Institute predicts that by 2025, solar energy can be produced at a levelized cost of 4 to 6 eurocents per kilowatt hours in Central and South Europe. This is well below the levelized cost of fossil fuels. We now have a better idea of the economics involved in the field of photovoltaics. This video concludes our discussion of solar energy. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did, and I wish you all good luck in engineering your very own PV system.